One yearbook has around 6 sample layouts, and this means we will recreate 31 layouts, and we will determine if it actually enhances our social skills, hand skills, and see what we learn from playing Thomas. This is the 1993 yearbook, a beautiful era where they made classical wooden railway sets. And our first mission? Building this cover page. That means we need the following items. Basically every 92 items, except for this cross track. Sorry, cross track. At first glance, everything looks normal, but I will tell you, there is nothing normal about this cover page. I know you guys want to see me replicate this as close as possible, so our journey starts here. The board. The board that we see on the cover page is actually hand-painted. The distinctive feature we see are the symmetrical charcoal roads, no brick floorings, and bushes, lakes, cloud logos, had some earth-shattering shit. Let's put the tracks on. There are three things about the tracks. Number one, the brown paint on the bumpers. Number two, the risers are shorter in dimension. Zooming in, you don't really see these gaps on the top and bottom. Ouch! Oh yeah, sharper edges too. Number three, the turntable. This is still a mystery. There are three variants of 1992 turntables that was released. Four female, two male, two females, six females. But in this picture, this is a three female, three male turntable. Buildings. Platform, station, breakfast house have darker roofs, dark green pillars, yawnies, and Roy's missing. The water tower has decal graphics and half stems. Yeah, the stem is important. Windmill is very interesting because the base is lost shorter just like the risers and uses 94 graphics. But also, the pattern of the blade is in reverse. Nature. Mr. Beast plants trees in real life.
Today, we will be planting 20 million trees.
Today, we will be planting 20 trees. In Thomas Wooden Railway. But prototype trees are interesting. Pamphlet trees have a different shade of green with glossy finish, and same goes with the seasonal trees. They painted the tree in one color first, then spray painted the top with the second color, and spray coated with gloss on the top. And that is why we see the initial colors on the bottom of the tree. We don't see that in the released version. Apple trees have round dots instead of the apple-shaped dots, and cows are shaped differently. Prototype cows actually have the ears and tail shaped, while the stickers are also meticulously cut around the edges. Released cows, on the other hand, yeah, let's populate the world. Now we have humans, we need laws. And this is where it's interesting because at first sight it looks like a version 2 sign, but it is not. Even the school, stop, railway signs are different in the sense that they fill in the woods more. One-way sign is longer, but yield sign, you could definitely tell the difference. If you ask me, they use the exact same signs as the pulled variant. This is my opinion, but I think the sickness could also be the same as the version 1. I could be wrong here. Trains. There are a lot of normals. Thomas to Percy, Annie, Clarabelle, Henrietta, Troublesome Trucks are normal release trains. But Toby, Mavis, Bill, Ben, Terrence, Harold are pamphlet variants. Now this is where it gets tricky. These Donald or Douglas, whatever they are, they both seem to have James's face. And that wraps up the 1993 yearbook layout. Level 1. From 1994 to 1998, each yearbook had 6 sample layouts, and the higher number we get into, the more harder it gets. Let's start with all the level 1s. 1994 and 1995 yearbooks only demonstrate the layout as a map, so we don't really know what it looks like in real life. For layout number 1, we need the following items, and the final layout looks. I don't know why that had to be so dramatic, but for layout number two, we need... And I just realized layout number one and two are same for both 1994s and 1995s. On layout number four, I found that the severity of the layout does not get as complicated as layout number three. Layout number three was 3D. This is 2D. And this is 1D. While doing layout number four, I was configuring the abbreviations. ST stands for straight track, CT stands for curved track. XT? I don't know what that is. So after an intense Google session, I learned... I still don't know what it is. Maybe they used X because the cross-track is shaped like an X. But oh my goodness, this layout is the layout that got me driving 12 hours to buy this table. This layout was supposed to come with pictures for the yearbook. This is the picture they took back then, and this is why I also decided to connect this layout with the 100-piece yearbook. Level 5. I mean Henry's day at the lumberyard. This is the list of stuff we need to build this layout, and let's get started. This truly felt like I was going back to being a kid. It really brought joy to my- Where's my action switch track? Okay, so because we didn't have the action switch yard track, we substituted with a regular switch track. I really love the aesthetics of the look, but I want us to get it into the final level. Up and down and all around.
I wanna be the very best, like no one ever was. To catch them is my real test, to train them is my cause. I will travel across the land, searching far and wide.
I was amazed at this layout. In this small table, it was able to fit 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6 lanes. With this layout, I feel like Henry's tunnel is the centerpiece, where it directs the track directions and brings out the three-dimensional look, while the Soda Bay Bridge brings texture. I know we joke about how Thomas doesn't improve our social skills, but look at us. We're holding strong as a community, and I get to talk with you guys. We also learn how to build, and I see a lot of you out there making your own versions of layouts. All I will say is it's very creative and beautiful.